I think first, you know, I think everybody in their coaching style has convictions, and I believe it's important to have convictions in what you deem that you know very well, what you coach very well, and then ultimately what your players do very well. So, you know, the advantage we have at the collegiate level is we recruit to try to fit into our system, obviously adapting when need be. You know, that's probably the biggest difference with high school is, you know, you're going to have to maybe change year to year. So for us, you know, I may have used this analogy when we spoke last time, I can't remember, but, you know, I treat my offense like my closet. And if I buy a pair of jeans and I get a new pair of jeans, I'm taking a pair of jeans out of my closet and I wear three pairs of jeans. So, you know, I know it sounds goofy, but that's kind of how we look at our run game. You know, if we were to add something, something has to come out. And it's one of those deals where, and it kind of, again, piggybacking on what I already spoke of, is it's easy to say, oh, you know, I saw this on social media. I listened to a guy speak on this, and it's a great concept. It's a great scheme. You know, we can install this. But then how do you find time to practice what you're adding in addition to what you've done? Because something is going to slip. You know, it would be fine for us maybe to have a fourth or a fifth run concept, but then at ultimately, can you really teach and get your kids to adapt to, you know, kind of what you spoke of with the odd fronts, right? You're going to see an even front team this week. You're going to see an odd front. You're going to see a team bouncing back and forth. And then you got your third down stunts and your twists and your blitzes. How do you get ready for all of that stuff? And it's already hard to get ready for all of it with three plays or four concepts, let alone a fifth or a sixth.